Q99.7, good morning, Brian Lee here. Well, I've got a guest in the studio today. It is Beth from American Red Cross. Good morning. How you doing?
Good morning, Brian. Thank you.
And you've got some smoke alarm stuff going on.
Yes, we do. Actually, this Saturday, November 7th, we're going to be hosting a free smoke alarm install. The Red Cross volunteers and also the West Lakes Fire Department is going to be in the Vienna Woods subdivision and pretty much going door to door, checking to see who's available and who's interested in talking about home fire safety and ask them if they're interested in a free smoke alarm install.
So if they live in that neighborhood, is it better just to wait till you come out there tomorrow, or would you like them to call ahead and schedule it?
Well, anybody, actually, if they're interested in a free smoke alarm, they are welcome to call the Wasilla office anytime they're interested in signing up for that. Actually, statewide, they can call their local offices. But if they're interested, certainly you can always call the local office. But Vienna Woods is the area we'll be in tomorrow. And if people are around, please come on out and say hi.
So they can get a free alarm, smoke alarm installed there. If you don't live in that subdivision, you can call 357-6060. And they'll add you to a list where they'll come out and actually install that.
Absolutely, yes. We have a pretty long list of dedicated volunteers that are absolutely excited about this program that we're running. So the home fire campaign is going to be running for the next 5 years, and so it's not a short window that we're working on. So if anybody is interested, please do call the office. Give us your name and number. We'll set you up on an appointment and have volunteers come out to visit you. One thing that's kind of important to us is we want to make sure that they're installed safely and correctly. And then also it gives us a great opportunity to talk to homeowners about home fire safety. Unfortunately, Americans were polled, and 65% of Americans feel that they have 5 to 10 minutes to get out of their home. And quite honestly, you have maybe under 2 minutes to get out of your home if there's a home fire. So that's a great opportunity for us to talk about home fire escape plans, talk to them about the safety with their children, education purposes across the board for any home in our area.
And it's also important to keep up on not just installing new fire alarms, but once you get them installed, there are some key points they say as into checking them. You've got to constantly check the alarms monthly. Also change the batteries and install a new battery if you hear the alarm chirp.
Absolutely. There's one thing that people really like to do is they like to take that battery out and say, oh, I'll get to that. You know, I'll replace that battery. But that's really critical. Never dismantle the smoke alarm if you can. If the battery is chirping, replace it right away. It's very critical for people's safety.
It's also important to let your children hear the alarm so they know what the alarm sounds like, because otherwise they wake up and they're like, what's that annoying sound?
Oh, yeah. Anytime you can train your children, household evacuation plans, escape plans are very important. If you guys can train that anytime during the day, do it at 2, 3 o'clock in the morning. Test your children. See if they know what to do if they hear that smoke alarm going off. Have a meeting place outside for safety purposes and make sure everybody knows that there's 2 ways to get out of every room in your home.
Very good information. So again, tomorrow, November 7th, going on from noon to 5, if you're in the Vienna Woods subdivision, the fire department will be over there, American Red Cross will be over there installing free smoke alarms. If you're not in that area, you can give the Wasilla office a call at 357-6060, add your name to the list, and they'll come out and install your smoke alarms also. Anything else you'd like to add?
No, that's a great amount of information too. If anybody else is interested in more information about what the Red Cross has to offer, they can go to our website at redcross.org/Alaska.
Thank you so much for coming in and letting us know about this.
Thank you so much, Brian.